ஹலோ ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ், ஐ ஆம் தர்ஷனா மோரே, அசிஸ்டன்ட் ப்ரொஃபெசர் ஆஃப் ஃபுட் சயின்ஸ், கேகேவா காலேஜ் ஆஃப் ஹார்டிகல்ச்சர். நவ் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சி அபவுட் கல்ச்சரல் மெத்தட் ஆஃப் வீட் கண்ட்ரோல். கல்ச்சரல் மெத்தட் ஆஃப் வீட் கண்ட்ரோல், இட் இஸ் செவரல் கல்ச்சரல் ப்ராக்டிசஸ் லைக் டில்லேஜ், பிளான்டிங், ஃபர்டிலைசர் அப்ளிகேஷன், இரிகேஷன் எட்ஸெட்ரா ஆர் எம்ப்ளாய்ட் ஃபார் கிரியேட்டிங் ஃபேவரபிள் கண்டிஷன்ஸ் ஃபார் த க்ராப். த ப்ராக்டிஸ் இஸ் யூஸ் ப்ராப்பர்லி help in controlling the weeds. In cultural methods, not only cultural method can control completely weed from the field, but it help in reducing the weed population. They should therefore be used to combination with other method like mechanical method, then biological method, chemical method, etc. Then in cultural methods, tillage, fertilizer application and irrigation are important. In addition, aspect like selection of varieties, time of sowing, then cropping system, cleanliness of the farm are also useful in controlling weeds. The first method of weed control is field preparation. The field has to be kept weed free. The flowering of weeds should not be allowed. That means the weed should completely remove before the flowering. This help in prevention of buildup of weed seed population. Second method is summer tillage. This practice of summer tillage or off-season tillage is one of the effective cultural method to check the growth of perennial weed population in a crop cultivation. Initial tillage before cropping should encourage the clod formation. This clod which have the weed propagules upon drying desiccate the same. The subsequent tillage operation should break the clods into a small unit to further expose the shriveled weeds to the hot sun. Then maintenance of optimum plant population. Lack of adequate plant population is prone to heavy weed infestation, which becomes difficult to control later. That means the higher plant population, lower the weed infestation. Therefore, the practice like selection of proper seed, right method of sowing, adequate seed rate, protection of seed from soil-borne diseases, pests, etc. are very important to obtain a proper and uniform crop stand capable of offering competition to the weeds. Next method is a crop rotation. The possibility of certain weeds species or a group of species occurring in a greater if the same crop is grown year after year. In many instances, crop rotation can eliminate, at least reduce, difficult weed problem. The obnoxious weed like Cyprus rotundus can be controlled effectively by including low land rise in crop rotation. Then growing of intercrops. Intercropping separates the weed better than sole cropping and thus provide an opportunity to utilize crops themselves as tools of the weed management. Many short duration pulses, for example green gram, soybean, effectively smoother weed without causing reduction in the yield of main crop. Then solarization. Solarization means the increasing the soil temperature up to the 5 to 10 degrees Celsius. This is another method of utilization of solar energy for desiccation of weeds. In this method, the soil temperature is further raised by 5 to 10 degrees Celsius by covering a pre-soaked fallow field with thin transparent plastic sheet. The plastic sheet checks the long wave back radiation from the soil and prevents loss of energy by hindering the moisture evaporation. Next method is mulching. This method is a protective covering of material maintained on the soil surface. The mulching has a smoothing effect on weed control by excluding light from the photosynthetic portion of a plant and thus inhibiting the top growth. It is very effective against annual weeds and some perennial weeds like Cynodon dactylon. Mulching is done with the help of dry or green crop residues, plastic sheet or polythene film. To be effective, the mulch should be thick enough to prevent light transmission and eliminate photosynthesis. Next one is the stale seed bed. A stale seed bed is a one where initial one or two flushes of weeds are destroyed before the planting of crops. This is achieved by soaking a well-prepared field with either irrigation or rain and allowing the weeds to germinate. At this stage, a shallow tillage or non-residual herbicide like paraquat may be used to destroy the dense flush of young weed seedlings. This may be followed immediately by sowing, and these techniques allow to the crop to germinate in almost weed-free environment. Then blind tillage. The tillage of the soil after sowing a crop before the crop plant's emergence is known as blind tillage. It is extensively employed to minimize weed intensity in a drill sowing crops where emergence of crop seedlings is hindered by soil crust formed on a recipient of rain and irrigation immediately after sowing. Then last one is the crop management practices. Good crop management practices that play an important role in weed control are: first is vigorous and fast growing crop varieties are better for the competitor with weeds. Then next one is the proper placement of fertilizer. This ensures the greater availability of nutrients to the crop, thus keeping the weed at a disadvantages. Then next, better irrigation practices have to a good head start over the weeds. Then proper crop rotation program, higher the plant population per unit area, resulting in smoothing effect on weed growth. Then some of the merits of cultural method. It is low cost method for the weed control and it is easy to adopt, no residual problem, technical skill is not required and no damage to the crops. It is effective for weed control and crop weed ecosystem is maintained. Disadvantages: immediate and quick weed control is not possible. Weed are kept under suppressed condition. Perennial and problematic weeds cannot be controlled and practically difficult in adoption. Okay, thank you.